Hello everyone, welcome to our channel, and from this lecture we are going to start our journey into cloud computing. So this is one of my favorite technology and very popular nowadays. So without further ado, let's get into it. So in the basic terms, cloud computing will provide us the meaning for accessing the applications as some utilities over the internet. So it allows us to create, configure and customize the applications online. So what really is a cloud? So this cloud term refers to the network or the internet, or we can say that the cloud is something which is present at the remote location. So cloud can provide the service over the public as well as the private networks. So applications such as email, web conferencing, customer relationship management execute on cloud. So the basic examples will be the Netflix, YouTube, which stores the data into cloud servers and we can access them over the applications just by using our internet. So the main advantage of this strategy will be you don't have to store all the videos of YouTube on your phone. Instead, you can access billions of videos from any device without storing them into your phone memory. So now let's talk about what is cloud computing. So the cloud computing refers to manipulating, configuring and accessing the hardware and software resources remotely. So it offers us online data storage, infrastructure and the application. So the cloud computing will offer the platform independency as the software is not required to be installed locally on your PC. So hence cloud computing is making our business applications collaboratively. So now let's talk about some basic concepts in cloud computing. So there are certain services and models working behind the scene, making the cloud computing very feasible and accessible to the end users. So, following I have given the two working models for cloud computing. The first one is a deployment model and second one is a service model. So, what actually mean by this? So, let's talk about them one by one. The first one will be deployment models. So, the deployment models define the type of access to the cloud. That is how cloud is located all over the world. So cloud can have any of the four types of access that I have given here. The first one is a public cloud, private cloud, community cloud and hybrid cloud. So what are their meanings actually? So the first one is public cloud. So this public cloud allows system and services to be easily accessible to the general public just like us. So the public cloud may be less secure because of its openness. It is just like an open platform system. The second one is private cloud. So the private cloud will allow the system and service only accessible within the organization. So it will be very secure because of its private nature. The third one is a community cloud. So the community cloud will allow systems and services to be accessible by the group of organizations. So it is just like private cloud, but the difference will be it can be accessed by the group of people or the organization, you can say. And the last one is a hybrid cloud. So hybrid cloud is a mixture of a public and private cloud in which the critical activities are performed using the private cloud while the non-critical activities are performed using the public cloud. So it is totally dependent of the activities that you are performing on the cloud and the security which you need to maintain for these activities. So this was all about the basic concept of deployment models in cloud computing. Now let's talk about the service models. So cloud computing is based on the service models. So these are categorized into three basic service models that I have given here. First one is a infrastructure as a service, which is called as a IaaS, platform as a service, which called as a PaaS, and last one is a software as a service, which is called as SaaS. But what is their meaning actually? Let's talk about one by one. So the first one will be IaaS. So the IaaS, which is infrastructure as a service, will provide the access to the fundamental resource such as physical machines, and virtual storage. So in this representation, I have given all the components and categorized them into the service models, in which blue ones are the ones you can manage on yourself on premise and the red ones will be managed by the cloud vendors from which we are buying the cloud services. So for on-premise mode, you have to manage all the things such as applications, data, runtime, middleware, OS, virtualizations, servers, storage, as well as networking. So all the things you have to manage if you go for on-premise. And the next three are the service models for cloud computing. So the first one that we have just talked about, in which you have to manage the application, data, runtime, middleware, and OS. But the virtualization, servers, storage, and networking. So these components will be managed by the cloud vendors which are providing the cloud service to you. The next one is a PaaS, which is platform as a service. So the platform as a service will provide the runtime environment for application, development, and deployment tools. So the three components you don't need to worry about, which are runtime, middleware, and OS. And you have to only manage applications and data, and all the other components will be managed by the cloud vendors. The last one is a SaaS, which is a software as a service, which allows us to use the software applications as a service to end users. So it is very simple. So all the things will be managed. So all the things that I have given here will be managed by the cloud vendors, and we will just use the applications as a service. But what about the benefits? So we have just talked about how the cloud computing works. But what are the benefits that I have given in this graphical representation? The first one is, we can access the applications as utilities over the internet. I have explained to you earlier with the example of YouTube. It is just an application that you can access over the internet, and you can play billions of videos on the go. The next benefit will be, we can manipulate and configure the applications online at any time. So according to your service model, you can configure your applications at any time on any device. You just need the internet and you can access it from anywhere. The next advantage is, we don't require to install a software for accessing and manipulating the cloud applications. The next advantage is, cloud computing is very highly cost effective because it operates at high efficiency with the optimum utilization. So it will just require an internet connection. That's how powerful the cloud computing is. And the last one is, cloud computing will offer the load balancing that makes it more reliable. So these were all the benefits of cloud computing. So enough of the advantages. Now let's talk about some drawbacks of cloud computing. The first and major one is the security and privacy. So it is very biggest concern about cloud computing, since the data management and infrastructure management in cloud is provided by the third-party cloud vendors, it will always be a risk to hand over the sensitive information to these providers. Although the cloud computing vendors ensures highly secured password protected accounts, any sign of security breach may result in loss of customers and businesses. The next one is a isolation failure. So this risk involves the failure of isolation mechanism, which will separate the storage, memory, and routing between the different tenants. And the next disadvantage is insecure or incomplete data deletion. So it is possible that the data requested for deletion may not be deleted. It happens because of some reasons, such as extra copies of data are stored but are not available at the time of deletion. That will be the one cause, or the disk that stores the data of multiple tenants is destroyed. This could be the also reason for incomplete data deletion. So these risks are involved in the cloud computing. So have to remember these points very clearly before implementing the cloud service in your organization. So this was just the basic overview of cloud computing, which will be enough to start our journey into world of cloud. So in the upcoming lectures, we will be covering all the topics of cloud computing with some simple and easy to understand examples. So if you like this lecture, please subscribe to our channel and also ring the notification bell to get the latest updates. And don't forget to follow us on our social media that I have linked in the description below. Thanks for watching.